Hello, everyone. Of course, my dogs are going to start barking the very second that I hit record. So I know that I haven't been on recording videos for quite some time, but honestly, I'm just not sure if I really wanted to record any videos, but I do. So I thought that I would show you a flipbook that I have made a couple times now for some pen pals of mine. I'm using the Paper Studio Make a Statement book. I think I found this one at Hobby Lobby. Found this at Hobby Lobby regular $19.99, and then I think I used a 40% off coupon. So pretty good deal, a ton of paper, some really cool patterns and stuff like that. So the first thing that I did is I went through, and I kind of like, I don't know, I just like to put colors together, or if I am doing a theme. So anyways, these are the papers that I picked out. And this mascara paper is going to be, I'm going to use it for the cover. So, let's do that. Let's do it. All right, I don't need this right this second. So for your cover, and this paper is 12 by 12. I'm also drinking, I just found this today. It is the Cherry Goza from Anderson Valley. Now, I've tried their Briny Melon and their Rosé. The Briny Melon is definitely a favorite, and this is a Cherry Goza that they've come out with. I found it at Total Wine. I think it was like $11.99 for a six pack, but it's pretty delightful. It's pretty tart, which I love. So that is my little beverage for today. Okay. So what you're going to do with your 12 by 12 paper, I always like to figure out, like, if it is a patterned paper, like, what direction I'm going to fold it. Like, will it be like this or will it be like this? So I'm going to go with my little mascara brushes. I love mascara. If I had to, like, I don't wear a lot of makeup much anymore, but, I think if I had to choose like one item of makeup, it would be mascara to wear. All right, and then I'm just gonna take my corner rounder and round off those corners. I just think it looks so nice, rounded corners. I kind of got into the rounded corner game a little late. And then what I do love is like when I order my Christmas cards, now, you know, they usually charge you extra for rounded corners. Well, you can just order those regular corners and then round them yourself. All right, so I'm always trying to figure out a glue because I'm never satisfied, but the one that I've gone back and bought is the, is it Aileen's? I think that's how you say it. I don't know. I'm just never satisfied with glue. I don't like a lot of wrinkles. I'm just very, I don't know, very picky. Do you find yourself being that way, fellow paper crafters? I don't know, never satisfied. All right, so I'm just gonna seal that down. I'm not gonna fold it yet because I'm not sure how thick everything's gonna be. So anyways, this is our cover folded in half, and then I just rounded the corners and glued it together, and then I'm just gonna put it over to the side here to let it dry. All right, so now I'm gonna take my great little cutting board here. Now listen, you don't need any equipment. I mean, I started out with nothing, so you know, scissors and folding it in the middle and cutting it in half is just as well. All right, okay. So again, I've got those papers turned the way I want. This is 12 by 12. I'm going to cut them in half. If I can get my paper to line up here. Okay. So I'm gonna cut those in half at 6. All right. Which is now gonna give us 6 envelopes. I do envelopes lots of different ways. This is just one way. So this is not the end all be all here. So first I take my strips of paper like so. And I'm just gonna kind of eyeball how much of a flat I want. Always keep in mind that you will be gluing these edges together. Maybe I should get in frame. You're always gonna be gluing these edges together. So just make sure that, you know, you're always gonna lose a little bit of that width when you glue it around the corners, if you decide to glue. All right, so now that I've got that, just going to fold the rest of my envelopes. And again, I'm just kind of eyeballing it because I want them all to be the same or relatively the same. I'm not. See, we've got 2 of each color. I'm not really digging. Oh, that's much better. So I also like to go through and like put them in the color order in which I'm gonna use it. All right. And then let's go ahead and corner round all of these as well. Just like we did with our cover sheet. So anyways, we're talking about all the things. Like, do you guys struggle with needing the newest pens or the... I struggle. I'm always like, no. And I try to have the, like, 30-day rule where if I really want, if I want something, I'm like, okay, well, I'm going to wait 30 days. Sometimes I don't make it. And then after 30 days, if I still want it, then I think Cindy Baldo is the one that I picked that up from, the 30-day method. You really want it. But then I'm like this is my hobby. You know, it could be a lot worse. Or that's what I tell my husband. It could be a lot worse. I could be into something, like, crazy. It's just a little snail mail. And you'll have to excuse my voice. I've been fighting this chest cold. Hi, little Rosie girl. Come to say hello. You hear tick-tacky feet. That's my little Pomeranian Rose. I'm sure you will hear her bark. Now, one thing I didn't do is I'm not gonna round these corners. Mainly just because I don't feel like it. All right, let's see. You kind of didn't line this up very well. Okay, So if this is our cover, I don't want that black and white one to be. I think I want which color do you guys think should come next? That yellow? I'm thinking that yellow. And then the black and white. Okay. Alright. So now that we've got all of our envelopes kind of pre-cut, here's the messiness of my board here. I should have wiped it down. Okay. So you can take whatever kind of twine string. I do not recommend using like just thread, like thread that you would sew with. I recommend something just like a little bit stronger. And you're just going to cut 6 pieces, all the same length. Now I just eyeballed this, but I've done several of these, so however long your envelope is, you just want to make sure that you've got enough room. I'm going to show you, hang on. Like enough room on either side of that. Can you guys see that? Flip it over. And then it'll start all coming together when we put it together. So anyways, let's cut our string. We need 6 pieces. In the middle. Okay, so anyways, now that you've got your string cut, you just want to take it and line it up again. I usually just eyeball it, pick it up, make sure that it's pretty much even before you glue it. And then don't do like I did the last time I made this and glue the tops of your envelopes shut, because that's no fun for anyone. So I'm just going to glue down the sides. Boop. Boop. Leaving my string in the middle and just sealing it up. Okay. So it looks like that. You've got 2 pieces of string that are hanging down and my envelope. So you can put that one to the side. That one's done. I'll do maybe 1 or 2 more. We don't need the glue yet. Get another piece of my string. Put it down again, making sure that it's even. Putting our glue down. The only thing I don't like buying these big old glue bottles, but this one was on sale, which is why I did this, because it takes longer for your glue to drop down. Constantly shaking it. Again, like this. So now that you can see, they're all like turned the same way. Now, here is what I'm trying to figure out. Do I want them all turned the same way? So like this first one, do I want it turned this way? So that it does look like a book, which I definitely think. I definitely think that I do. But then when I open it this way, should this one look like another page in the book, or should it look like an envelope? That's my question. What do you guys think? Comment down below, like, subscribe, all those wonderful things. Give me a thumbs up. Don't be mean, it'll hurt my feelings. So I think I like doing them like this, where it's like every other one, where it's like the flap of the envelope. Okay. Yeah, we're gonna go with it like this. So I'm just folding down all these flaps so I can get an idea. So that would literally mean they're all facing the same way, right? Yep. Okay. I know, sorry, but of course my camera stopped recording. I knew it was gonna happen at some point. But you didn't miss much. I was just continuing to fold down these envelopes. Please don't look at my nails. They're terrible. I ordered these. I love the in coconut nail wraps. They're like, I can only find them at Walmart or online. Okay. But anyways, I ordered these other ones that my sister told me to order off of Amazon, and they were total crap. But I ordered a buttload ton of them. Okay, so now you kind of see our book coming together. Now I'm going to take our cover. And put our little envelopes inside there. Line it up however you want. Now, this is why I don't fold this, because I always like to see how. Come on, this. Okay. Took all that back. Oh, I think that's nice. So I think here, and then I think that we'll bring this little guy over to the front and give it a nice crease. So it's still got some room. So just see how I did that? Just folded it around. If you didn't want this flap, you could certainly cut it off so it would just be, you know, open-ended. But I like the little flap. And then now I'm going to show you how to tie it all together. Use my glue bottle here. So now that we've got all the strings on this side, just gonna give it a little knot. I usually hold this in between my legs. Now, you don't want to pull too tight, but tight enough that it's gonna keep your little envelope flip book together. So I always say pull the string, not the paper. Another little tight knot right there. So you can see how I did that. Now, at this point, you could leave it just like this if that's what you wanted. You can give this a little trim. I, however, like to take it, because I'm all for the reusing, or at least using everything that you have. So I like to also close it right here. Now, it doesn't account for, I mean, it is going to make it a little bit more bulky. And then I would knot it again. But first, I want to fill this up and maybe decorate it a little bit. I'm not sure. Maybe that's for a different video, the decorating part. This one's already been kind of long. But as you see, like, super simple, right? Not hard. Aliens, get out of the way. So you've got your little book here, along with your flap. Again, I usually wrap the string around to secure it. You can always secure it with a washi. You can sew a little button on, and use some of this extra twine to do it that way. But I usually like to decorate the inside cover. I will decorate the outside too. I usually put like hello and then the person's name, and then decorate this inside cover. And then I love to put all the goodies in it. So every little envelope, you know what, these envelopes dry some more, will have a goodie. And then you can also decorate the other page. So it is truly like a little book when you're flipping through here. You see they're all together. We've kept them all bound up together. They're not going anywhere. And then sometimes I debate, like, do I decorate it, you know, because again, people's styles, maybe, I always try to close it with washi so that it can be removed. But anyway, it's just a cute little envelope flip book. And then you really do have a lot of room, to really fill it up with some nice goodies. There's plenty of space in there. So anyways, just a quick little flip book tutorial. I hope y'all enjoyed this. I'm Nancy. I'm the Artful Alpaca. I'll see you guys soon. All the love and light.